Hello, Gundam fans, this is Bar92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 high-grade Galbaldy Beta from Gundam Zeta. Yeah, this is a model kit I don't know anything about, but I do like the way it looks, and I have to say, I guess the people who made it were thinking there's not a lot to it, so let's go to town on the actual, like, model, because this thing, it's pretty good. As a side skirt falls off, well, it's a polycap peg. Not a big deal. But lots of detail. All the seam lines are gone. Like, these are two hats, but the molding, it's not visible. The legs, that's, like, detailed. Same thing here. That's a panel line all the way down the legs. Same thing with the arms. There's detail on the other side to match the seam line. And this part is another piece. So yeah, they did a really good job. Why is this side skirt not staying on? Stupid polycap. But yeah, it holds the other well, so I don't know why that's doing that. But it looks good. I got the sticker for the model one, which has like a crosshair in it. Which is, I think is different. And that's the only sticker on the body. Everything else is plastic. I like the center here. Like, this is all different plastic in here. Yeah, I really do like it. This thing, I don't, like I said, I know nothing about it, but I really like it, and since it's the beta, I hope there's another version. I have to go online and check. But just this model alone, really, really well designed. So the head is double ball jointed. So it's pretty free. The model eye does not move, unfortunately. I wish it did. The arms are really cool. First off, you have a track that pulls the shoulder joint out, and then it allows it to go up all the way that far. You can also move it forward at that new joint that you pulled out. It locks into place with one click. So that's pretty cool. The arm itself is ball jointed, and then you rotate. Below, is it actually? No, I'm afraid I lied. It does not rotate. I was thinking there, but I forgot. This part here stops it. It, like, locks all together. But you have a rotation at the elbow. Makes up for it. And then you have the double-jointed elbow. And the ball-jointed wrist. You have a ball... Let me just pull it up to show you. So you got this weird joint. It's a swivel. And then a hinge. And then the ball-joint polycap, which... Ugh. And, it goes in like that at the front. So you can kind of get forward and side to side and some rotation at the chest. But don't go too far forward, it comes right out, because it was, again, polycap ball joint. But that's neat. Other models do use that. And then the ball-jointed waist, mostly swivel. Yeah, the ball-jointed front skirts, which are mostly just forward and back. The hinge side skirts, not too much. Legs into the jing-jing-jing. You can go forward, a little back. Out as far as the side skirts will allow. They would go farther if it wasn't there. Rotate the thigh. It's a nice, it's not super tight. It's rather easy to move it, but it's locked in there with the leg armor, so it's not coming off. Then you have the double jointed knee. You have a, now this is the only part I find is limited in the kit, is the ankle. Because they have this whole armor here which stops it. If they made it like the old Zaku 2s, where you have a double hinge that pulls out, it would really help the articulation, but right now it's just forward and back, and then some side to side, and some rotation. So it is, it really stops the kit from being amazing in terms of the articulation. I really wish they had made that into a Zaku 2 ankle. But even with the way it is, it's still very good articulation. So it looks like I was right about the beam saber handles in the unboxing. Those, I guess, are the beam saber handles, and you have a set of normal ones, and you have a set of clear yellow beams, which fit nice and tight into these hands, which is good. Then you have the shield, which is a whole GP01 thing, or the Mark II shield, where that's a storm mode, and then peg it down here, and now it's the extended mode, and then you have a yellow sticker here, Got some extra ammo, I guess that is, for the, I don't think it's for the gun. I'm not really sure what that's for. Maybe they fire... They might fire rockets. I don't know. You have a connector here that can rotate. And it'll ping onto the other side of the arm. Right there. And then you have the... I assume it's a beam rifle. Once again, I need to look at this stuff. Sticker for the scope. Extra trigger finger hand, which... a little loose. There's no actual peg in there. But it holds it fine. And that whole thing on the instructions that say to lift the wrist up, I guess that helps. I don't really find it. There's also a slight bend in the ball joint for the beam rifle hand. So it does allow the hand to hold it and have it almost straight. Just to get around that stock. Yeah, and those are the accessories. Very few, but they look okay. They're unique, that's for sure, like their design. I don't really see anything like those, I don't think. And they hold well. So somebody in the unboxing video mentioned this was like a, what was it, a go-go that went to the gym. I can't find the one go-go I have that, Chima custom, was it? Some of that. I can't find it. It's on the shelf somewhere, but it was, must be behind something. But anyways, there it is next to a Zaku 2, the half cannon. Let me get this guy straightened up. So, think of all the beta is taller, and then here it is next to a ground gym. So the Galbaldy beta is definitely taller than a standard mobile suit. And that's the high-grade Galbaldy Beta. I really like it. A lot, like, for knowing nothing about it, they took the model and they made it really good. There's all this extra articulation in the upper body, and the way it looks with no seam lines that I can tell. They did a great job of hiding that. Once again, the ankles is the only thing that really weighs it down in terms of articulation. If they had modified that joint and give it a double ball joint to pull out, it would have helped to get around the ankle armor, but... As you can see, that's it. It's got a ball joint and a hinge. And there's just not enough space to work around that, unfortunately. So I'm sure someone can modify that, but yeah, it's a little annoying. Get in there, you. But besides that, it's still a great looking kit. A great constructed kit. And just, I want other versions of the Galbaldy Beta now. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.